Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And we will be seated. I want to give glory to God. Yeah. Today the Lord has sent me to you again. The message is still the same. He has sent me to go and speak to you. To go and speak to you on a message that is titled Occupy Till I Come. Tap your neighbor and say Occupy. Till I come. Let's open our Bibles to the book of Luke chapter 19. We're only going to read one verse there. The book of Luke chapter 19. We are going to read just one verse there, verse number 13. All of us will read that verse together, the book of Luke, chapter 19. We are all going to read verse 13 together. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
Let's go together. So he called 10 of his servants, delivered to them 10 minas, and said to them, do business till I come. One more time. So he called 10 of his servants, delivered to them 10 minas, and said to them, do business till I come. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is a story that is similar to the one that we read in the book of Matthew. It is the story of a nobleman, a wealthy man, a famous man, a dutiful businessman that was going on a trip. When he was going to go on a trip, the Bible said he gathered 10 out of all his servants. He isolated 10, just like a pastor would gather some people and say, these are going to be the workers of this church. He gathered 10 of them and he gave them talents. He gave them minas one by one. And he told them, occupy till I come. He told them, do business till I come. The occupy here is not like the occupy Wall Street. It's not like the sitting by the entrance of Wall Street and disturbing business. The Bible is talking about go and do business with this one.
Yes,
this is an opportunity that I have opened for you. Go and profit with this opportunity. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tap your neighbor and say, occupy till I come.
Occupy till I come.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The assignment of Jesus Christ for you and I is that you need to go and occupy. He has opened up the land of America to you. He has opened up your workplace to you. He has opened up your extended family to you. And he has charged you to occupy till he comes. All he wants you to do is to tell them about himself. He wants you to tell them about Jesus Christ. He wants you to be his representative in your family. He wants you to be his mouthpiece at your workplace. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Occupy till I come. Do business till I come.
Yeah.
Why is this necessary? Why is this message necessary? We've spent 3 days saying the same thing in diverse of ways. It is necessary because your book is still open.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tap your neighbor and say your book is still open.
Your book is still open.
One day he's going to come back. The Bible says that the nobleman came back. And when he came back, he asked the people, the servants, for account. One came and said, the one you gave me, I have been able to get 10 more. The other one came and said, you gave me one, I've been able to get 5 more. And one came and started to give excuses. Rather than get commendation, the Bible says that man got a curse. You will not get a curse.
Amen.
Occupy till I come.
Jesus.
When Jesus was here, there was no need at all for an apostle. He was the chief of them all. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There was no apostleship or title when he was here. When Jesus was here, there was no need for any prophet. What kind of a better prophet can you get than him? He was the best of all prophets. He was the one that can predict eternity even from now. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When he was here, there was no need for evangelists. We were of no title. He was all in all for all of us. Hallelujah. He has the ability to fill the stadium with people without any TV advertisement. That was our God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He needed no evangelist. He was the only evangelist, the one, the chief of them all. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Yeah. There was no need for any pastor when he was here. Nobody was called pastor. Occupy till I come. No need for any pastor. Do you need any shepherd if you have Jesus Christ as your shepherd? There was no need for any shepherd. It was the chief of all shepherds. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And anything that is kept in his care, the Bible says they are saved. So there was no need for pastors. There was no need for teachers. He is called master. The one that has, can divide the world with simplicity for anybody to understand. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He was the rabbi that was among the people.
Yes,
the one that knows how to divide the word of God with simplicity. So there was no need for any minister, any teacher. But when he was going away, he said to you and I, occupy till I come. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Be the apostle till I come.
Yes, sir.
Be the prophet till I come.
Hallelujah.
Fulfill your ministry as an evangelist till I come. Be the pastor. That's why we are all relevant. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Be the teacher. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Occupy till I come. Tap your neighbor and say,
occupy.
Let's go to the book of Ephesians chapter 4. All of these offices were not there while he was around. Just like that master, that nobleman left. Jesus left and gave us this assignment. And he's going to come back to ask for account. My prayer for you, on that day of account, you will not be speechless.
Amen.
Hey, you know the one that made 10 quickly ran forward and said, you gave me one look, I have made 10. On that day of account, you will not be speechless.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
He has sent me to you to go and charge you and encourage you. Occupy till he comes. Ephesians 4, 11 to 13. The Bible says, and he himself gave some to be apostles. There is talking about Jesus Christ. He gave some to be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, and some pastors, and some teachers, for the equipping of the saints for the work of ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to a perfect man, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tap your neighbor and say, occupy.
Till
he comes.
Yeah.
You are going to do the business of the kingdom that till he comes. This is how you are going to do it. You are going to do it like he was doing it while he was here.
My God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Everywhere he went,
he
was doing good.
Oh.
Almighty,
oh.
He healed the leper. When the cripple saw him,
he
started to
walk.
Everywhere he went,
my
Lord is doing good. You are going to go everywhere you go.
My God.
You must be a change agent. That is how to occupy till it comes. When you get to a place where there is darkness, as a child of God, your presence must bring light to that place.
Amen.
When you are told of a marriage that is not working, as a child of God, just by knowing it and what you are going to do, must turn things around in that home. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
At your workplace, you are going to occupy that place till it comes.
Hallelujah.
You are going to win souls for him over there at your job place.
Yeah.
Your extended family, you still have some of them that are not believers yet. Occupy till he comes. You are going to tell them about the love of God, about the love of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What are you going to tell them? Tell them, number one, that Jesus is the source of a better life here on earth. You can have it both ways. Jesus. Hey, Jesus. Can everybody say Jesus?
Jesus
is the source of better life here on earth. When I met with the Lord, my story changed. When I met with the Lord, my story changed. When I met with the Lord, my story changed. My story changed. When I met with the Lord, my story changed. I have met an Oshubi that is a Christian. If you understand the meaning of that name. A Famuyide that is a Christian. Okundele is Christian. Occupy till I come. It is that there is someone occupying. That's why I'm a good day to be a Christian. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't know whether they do that, those things in where pastor came from. Tell them that Jesus is the source of a better life. Here or not? You want to live it good? You want the devil to flee from you? You better embrace him. Tell them. You want a new job? Tell them he can provide.
Jesus.
You want a new house? You want to be married? You want to have children? Tell them that he can do all that. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He's our burden bearer. Anyone that is here today burdened in one way or the other, I pray in the name of Jesus that the Lord will lift your burden.
Amen.
He has the power to bring financial buoyancy and career advancement.
Amen.
We live in a country where a lot of people use the phrase, I'm depressed all the time. Tell them that there's an alternative to depression. That Jesus is the one that can uproot depression. Uproot depression. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You're going to share the Bible passages like this with them. Matthew 11, 28 to 29. The Bible says, come to me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your soul.
Nice.
Simple passages. You're going to share like John 3, 16 with them, for God so loved the world. I gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him, black or white, whoever, should not perish but have everlasting life. Acts 14, 12. Nor is there any salvation in any other. For there is no other name under heaven under which men by which we must be saved. Tell them about Acts 3:19. Repent therefore and be converted. That your sins may be blotted out, so that the times of refreshing may come from the presence of the Lord. You're going to share those heart-lifting, life-transforming passages with them. You're going to tell them at your workplace, but you must stand out for him. They must first of all know that you belong to him. Hallelujah. Have your neighbor say, occupy it till I come. Number two, you're going to tell them that Jesus is the source of a better life in eternity. How many of you know that we are going to live forever?
That's it.
Yes.
We are, whether you like it or not, whether you believe it or not, you are going to live forever.
Yes,
what we are all fighting for is where we are going to live our eternity. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's either hell or heaven. What you are doing today will determine where. Yes. Hallelujah.
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 If that one is too complicated, go and look for a young woman or a young man that is not following God now. You will still be alive when they become men and women. You will see what their lives will look like by the foundation that they are laying now. If a child at the age of 16, 17 is sleeping around or is drinking around, is doing all the vices, wait for them. When they turn 45, you will see the reflection of the activities of that age 16, 17 reflecting upon them. If you see a child that is going to school, that is studying hard, that is studying hard, that is studying hard, don't be jealous of that child when that child becomes a doctor tomorrow. The reflection of what was done when they were young. Hallelujah. Whatsoever you are doing today, it's going to reflect on what you become tomorrow. Hallelujah. Tap your neighbor and say, occupy till I come. Hear this. Hear this. Hear this. How many of us know that food is good?
Super.
How many of us? Somebody gave a testimony and said that the doctor recommended to go and eat. He was having headache.
Right.
Headache, headache, headache. And they tried, just like my brother said, they said go to scan and all of that. But at the end of the day, went to a doctor and I've just eaten, but I'm not having the headache now. The doctor said, okay, go and keep eating. Food is good. Hallelujah. Maybe you don't do it every day because you are Christians, but there are people that if they don't do it, their bodies will be shaking. If they Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We feed our bodies because of what? So that this body can remain alive.
Yes, sir.
Occupy till I come.
Amen.
You want, you see, scientists said you can only live for about 3 days or 4 days, depending on your body weight, if you have no water at all. No food, no water. Maybe without food, you can live for 6 weeks. But by the time we finish 6 weeks, you'll be as tiny as this, depending on your body weight. You'll be shrinking by the day. That's how important food is. We know it, and that's why we do it every day. We stock our fridges because we want to live. Hallelujah.
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 Anyone that is not here now at this hour is starving the spirit. The way you feed your body is the same way you are expected to feed your spirit. If you fail to feed your spirit, the spirit that you fail to feed will kill the body that you have fed. You didn't understand that? If you fail to feed your spirit with this bread of life that we are eating now, with the word of God, with the things of God, the body that you have already taken care of, you've given all the good food, you go to Applebee's to feed this body, that spirit that you fail to feed will kill the same body. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Have you ever heard on TV a celebrity, very beautiful, very wealthy, very everything, food is not a problem for them, commit suicide or drop themselves to death? It is because they fail to feed their spirit. The body that they were feeding killed, the spirit they were not feeding killed the body that they were feeding. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tell the people that you are going to live in eternity, but you can have it both ways. If only you can embrace this Jesus, he will feed your spirit and there will be no junk in your system.
Oh,
hallelujah.
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 We watched a little clip of video in our couple's night, and in that video, a woman that was married to a nice man wanted to divorce the nice man. What was her complaint? The man was too nice. She said the man was making her fat because before the early morning, the man would have cooked and bring food and doing coffee. The man was practically like a slave to the woman. But the background of that woman was where abuse was. She was expecting to be beaten, to be kicked and all of that, but she wasn't getting that. Junk in her spirit. And the judge told her that I can only describe you as stupid. Occupy till I come. Tell them that is the way to live a better life tomorrow. Yes, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And when you do that, guess what? The Lord will return blessing unto you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
What are the things that we are expected to do? What are the things that could render us ineffective? I run through them quickly. We need to pray. Number one, you are not going to be an effective minister of God if you have unforgiveness. has a spirit operating in your life. And I pray today, every form of unforgiving spirit in your heart, the Lord will break them.
Amen.
A pastor that cannot forgive will not prosper in ministry. You cannot be effective in ministry. Take an usher that cannot forgive. Hallelujah. That usher cannot go far in ministry. People are going to step on your toes. They are going to call you names. You cannot represent God if you are going to be mindful of all of those things. Hallelujah. Occupy till I come. Anyone that is carnality is not going to make you to be effective. Carnality. Carnality means being worldly. Elevating things that are not spiritual more than things that are spiritual. Even eating can become a carnal stuff, depending on how you approach it. Carnality can render you ineffective. Hallelujah.
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 There was a man that in the scriptures, it was food that messed his life up even before it started. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Carnality can render you ineffective. I want us to pray. Disobedience is another one. Disobedience.
Anyone that is a disobedient Christian
cannot be effective in doing this work. Don't forget, occupy till I come. The nobleman came back for accounts. And this man with the one talent started to complain that I know you as as a mean person. Giving all the excuses that he could give for doing nothing. But at the end of the day, he was cursed. You will not be cursed.
Amen.
I want to encourage you. Go to the highways and the byways. You have all it takes to prosper in ministry. You have all it takes to do well as a church. If you will do your part, and I will do my part, you will see this church blossom.
Hallelujah.
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 Till I come. Let us all rise. We're going to pray. You are going to pray. You are going to tell Jesus, I will not be a disappointment. That man was a disappointment because he was given equal opportunity. God has given all of us. He's an equal opportunity God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do you know that there are ministries in Norfolk here? Yes, that are yet to be developed.
Yes,
it's just looking for one man to say, I will spearhead that one. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Those who are not there, the pastor, there's nothing to do. Much to do. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Occupy till I come.
Yes.
You're going to tell Jesus, I will not be a disappointment to your kingdom.
Amen.
Lord, watch over my spirit, assist me. For 3 days now, I have told you the benefits, the rewards of following instructions, of doing the will of God. I am still there. That's why I start every day when I speak to you, and even in COGA Cathedral, that the word of the Lord that I hear today will transform my life.
Amen.
It is meant to transform your life.
Yes, sir.
That all the things that you are doing before that are not good, you are doing them no more. Tell Jesus, I need your help. I will not be a disappointment. Lord, help me to occupy, to do your business, and to do it with profit. Shall we pray? In the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, divine God. The assignment is that we will all go out there to do something. The assignment is that we all go there to tell someone about you. Holy Spirit, oh Lord Jesus, we pray that you will help us to occupy. You will help us to occupy. You will help us to occupy. That your business will not be lying on the ground in our hands.
Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. And this work will progress and your kingdom will advance. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray. It's so weak. You're going to move to the front. I'm going to tell you what I told the people in the morning. Move to the front, everybody. All of us, we're going to pray. Well, I'm going to tell you how you're going to pray. You were not here. Maybe that's the reason you're praying. We prayed very well in the morning. Extremely well. People in the neighborhood, they had us. And we were not even as many as this. They had us. You're going to open your mouth wide. You are going to pray. You are going to pray. Our father, the apostle, gave us an instruction. I'm talking about the apostle, but that is the founder of this ministry. The instruction is that when we want to pray, it doesn't matter how they do it on the other side or what they are doing on this side, but if we are here and we want to pray, we're going to call the name of Jesus Christ powerfully 3 times and begin to declare. Begin to declare. Begin to declare. What you are doing, in essence, you are saying that I rely upon the name. I have to declare it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And that's what I expect you to do. We're going to, in unison, all of us together, 3 times. Then everybody start to declare their own. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In the morning, I told them, I said, I noticed one thing. Because God led me this direction, and I was asking myself, but looking at what we've been studying in Bible study, even the song that was sung here, we sang a song that says deliverer, deliverer, protector, and all of that stuff. The Sunday school book has for this month, it's a month of Christmas. It's a month of Christmas. I begin to wonder, why do we have deliverance and defender in that book for December? It was written in 2014. For the year 2015. I don't know why. Why are we talking about Peter that is chained down in December? There must be a reason God put that. So we cannot go but pray some of those prayers in that passage. So you are going to get there and talk to God. You're going to tell Jesus. Powerfully you say the name of Jesus powerfully. You're going to say to Jesus, peradventure there is anyone that is tied down like Peter. I venture there's anyone in CSC, WOSEM, Norfolk, in Postmont, Mountain, in Virginia Beach, in CSC, WOSEM, COGA Cathedral, and all over CSC, WOSEM in America. I venture there's anyone that is tied down. Jesus was not the one that tied Peter down.
No.
God was not the one that tied Peter down. The devil was the one that tied Peter down in the name of Herod. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are going to declare and say, Jesus, anyone that is tied down here, release them.
Yes.
He had the power without any sword to break chains.
Yes.
You are going to declare in the name of Jesus that anyone that is tied down, release them. Set them free. Set them free. That must be the reason you put those passages together for us. Say, Lord. Say, Lord. I want to hear you. Say, Lord. Say, Lord. Anyone that is tied up by the devil, release them. Shall we pray? Oh, in the name of Jesus. As you did in the life of Peter, you release Peter. I ask Holy Spirit that you release them in the mighty name of Jesus. Any member of this church, any member of CSU Water, and it's time now, even at this time as we are ending the year 2015, release them, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray.
Let our amen be together.
Amen.
Forget that this is not an issue of debate. It's not an issue of debate. Some people are still going to be slaughtered by the devil before the end of 2015. It's not an issue of debate. I've gone to the hospital before and I stood in front of the hospital and I said, Jesus, empty this hospital. Empty this hospital. When I came to my senses, I realized that Jesus didn't put people there. The devil put people there.
And he will go there, Jesus himself, and pick his own from there.
Yes.
And leave the one that belongs to him, to the devil. If the devil likes it or not, come pick them up. But the devil does not joy in picking anybody out, because his mission, his ministry is to steal, to kill. That's his ministry. So he's happy that someone is tied down. So you are going to tell Jesus, release. The Bible says we declare a thing and it shall be established. So you are going to declare in the name of Jesus. Your destinies are tied to some other people. When they are sad, it will affect you. So you are going to tell Jesus, anyone among us, whether they are here or they are not here, that is tied up by the devil to be slaughtered. Anyone in my family that is destiny or her destiny is tied to mine, release that now, shall we pray? Anyone that a pit is already dug for. You are going to tell Jesus, the one that dug the pit, let them begin to fall into this pit. There are levels of danger. There are levels. There are some dangers that you pray, keep my enemy alive. But there are some enemies. You are saying to God, keep ISIS alive. You are telling men to slaughter more people. There are some levels. The one that is still tickling you is the kind of problem you can say, keep my enemies alive, let them see when the tickling is over. But when he's biting you hard, you tell Jesus, demolish them. He's the one that knows the style he's going to use. Some will self-destroy themselves. You are going to tell Jesus. You are going to tell him that every and anyone that any pit is dug for, the owner of that pit, the one that dig the pit, let them begin to fall into that pit. Let them begin to fall into that pit. Say, Lord, say, Lord, any pit that the enemy has dug for me and my family, let the enemy begin to fall into that pit. Shall we pray? Pray in the name of Jesus. Pray in the name of Jesus. Pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Every pit that the enemy has dug, every pit that the enemy has dug, in the mighty name of Jesus, yes, let them begin to fall into that pit, in the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' name we pray. Our God is a total package. If you were not here yesterday, now you meet some. Because yesterday we prayed some prayers, they were blessings for ourselves. We called Jesus Jehovah Jireh, we asked him to provide for us. We asked him to give us peace. We asked him to be present with us, to be our shepherd at all times. Those were our prayers. If you were not here, you are going to tell Jesus. The book of 1 Kings chapter 13, there was a king, a very wicked king. A man of God went to town to go and deliver the message of the Lord, but that king stretched an evil hand. You're going to tell Jesus, anyone among us here, that any evil hand is stretched to, let those hands begin to wither. Let those hands begin to wither. Let those, maybe the hand was stretched to your marriage or to the life of your children, wanting them to be wayward. Every evil hand that is stretched to you in the order of Jeroboam, in the order of Jeroboam, let us and begin to wither, shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. My life is in your hand, that of my wife and my children. Every other evil hand that is stretched towards us, I command in the name of Jesus, let us begin to wither. altar, God. The Bible says that the king put an altar together. There was an altar of evil. You're going to tell Jesus. At the end of that story, that altar of evil was demolished. You're going to tell Jesus. Every evil altar erected against me. One man gave a testimony in the morning. They said he went into the bush and something was hidden there. There was an evil altar. Human being did that. He was an evil altar. You are going to tell Jesus. They are not going to tell you that we are putting an evil altar together. But God sees and he can demolish such an altar. You are going to tell Jesus that every evil altar erected against me, erected against my spouse, erected against my children, today, the 13th of December, Lord God Almighty, begin to demolish them. Begin to demolish them. Jehovah! Jesus, Lord God Almighty, every water that is erected against me and my household, I ask now, God Almighty, that you begin to demolish them. Scatter them now in the name of Jesus. Begin to demolish them, Holy Spirit, in the mighty name of Jesus. Render them powerless. Thank you, Lord God Almighty. In Jesus' name. Blessings upon your life. There are people that will still make it before the year ends. There are people that are still breakthrough before the year ends. There are people that still get their green card. There are people that are still make. Some people will conceive before the end of the year. You are going to begin to declare upon your life. Tell Jesus, I will be taller than my enemy. Guess what? At the end of the day, David was taller than Saul. I will be taller than my enemies. You are going to tell Jesus, when I dig my well, this remainder of the year, I will find water. Isaac dug his own well in the land of Gerar, a land that was very dry. He was finding water. What was impossible for others was possible for him. I will lend to nations. I will not borrow. Tell God some good things and I pray and declare blessings upon your life. Shall we pray? In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I will dig my wells to the water. I will find water, Lord. I will be taller than my enemies. In the mighty name of Jesus. In this walk of ministry, you will live in health. My wife, my children, we will live in health.